from the lush green lands to the cascading waterfalls, wonders of the world, the oldest habitat of territories on earth, a rich cultural heritage, a continent of 1.1 billion people, second largest and most populous, a continent pregnant with possibilities, home for 30% of Earth's mineral resources, 50% of its people under 25 years. Africa, the land of the great. Our spirit, resilient. Our enterprise, profitable. Our future, inspiring. Africa is inspiring. Be inspired.
Africa has over 50 countries struggling for survival. The question we need to ask is it that the barber does not know how to cut hair, or that the implement is blunt? The truth of the matter is that we've not told ourselves the truth. Colonialism and the after effect of colonialism, which is new colonialism, has not helped us. We also have not helped ourselves because our people say, whoever is rejected does not reject himself. We have allowed ourselves to keep being tied to the apron strings of Europe and other parts of the world. Meanwhile, those parts of the world are actually expecting us to rise to the occasion and become our own people and have an identity. I ask the question, why would we continue to explore and exploit raw materials from the ground that God has given us? The Congo alone has over 250 minerals in the ground, but it's a war-torn area, because we are concerned about corruptly enriching ourselves as individuals rather than jointly working to create wealth for the community and everybody is happy at the same time. Must I be the only rich person in my community where over 2,000 other people depend on me and I become the number one, the wealthy one of that community? It doesn't make sense. I think it has to do with mindset and is wrong. A Sapele proverb will tell you, talking to our young Africans, because it's clear to me right now that the only people that can save Africa are Africa's youth. We need to understand that we are the ones that are at risk here. The older generation will simply die. Chronologically, many of them are already over 50, and if they didn't do it when they were young, when their blood was bubbling, when are they going to do it? So we need to save ourselves, take up the gauntlet and save ourselves. It's time for us to stand up, to understand, like the Sapele proverb would say, if you do not step out of your hut, you will not see the moon shining. If we need to travel, let's travel, but with an eye to understand. Do what Singapore did. Lee Kuan Yew, from third world to first, would tell you that they picked up young Singaporean young people, indoctrinated them with the idea that they needed to go understand the know-how of technology in the West. The same thing the Japanese emperor did in the Wakura mission. If you Google it, go look at the Wakura mission. Got there and looked at the antiquated technology of Europe and brought it back, broke it down, and decided to add value to it. Which brings me to the next thing. We keep digging up these things and shipping to Europe. So we send cocoa out and it comes back as Ovaltine. We ship palm oil out, it comes out as cream, which we still use here. At the end of the day, it becomes double jeopardy. Even with the fall in oil prices, what do we see? You send a gallon of crude oil out as Nigeria and some other African countries, Angola and the rest, and it goes to the West where they have refineries that are working. And what do they bring back to us? Petrochemicals end products, which give you, on a barrel of oil, you sell for $27 a barrel. The residues that come out from it, the things that come out of it, will give you over $300. What are we doing to ourselves? It's time for us to wake up. It's time for us to understand that only us can help ourselves. And the reason I do not believe in job creation is because I've understood that no government can employ all the people of any nation. So we need to get entrepreneurial. And that's why I use the Sapele proverb, if you do not step out, you will not see the moon shining. But the government needs to help us. Or we in the private sector may need to help ourselves to create a private sector mindset to things and begin to understand that we and we alone can help ourselves. There's already corruption in Africa. Let's not deny and begin to play the ostrich and put our head in the sand. There is corruption in Africa. And I believe strongly that nobody's going to come to my company and convince me to defraud my own company. So I believe that when people set up their own businesses, they're well able to understand that they alone can help themselves. You cannot keep deceiving yourselves. It's time for us to work and get our hands dirty and get down in the trenches and build wealth for Africa. What we are asking for is just our own space. Create an enabling environment for us to do our own things, create our own wealth, and pay you tax as government. And then those of us in the private sector need to do advocacy. We need to also get together and keep an eye on government and be the ombudsman, the security man that gets government on her toes and to understand. Now we're beginning to lose even people in very high offices, in plane crashes, on the road. Now, it makes a lot of news because they are prominent people, but on a daily basis, people die in Africa on top of water because the boats are shafts and not any canoe-powered well, and you have piracy and all of that. Can we talk to ourselves? Even if you're an armed robber and you're listening to me right now, please stop. Let's get together and work together. I promise you that when we work together, you won't need to steal. It's even cheap for you to steal what I have produced. How does it make you feel? And even if you're a young lady here, stand up to be counted. The Okonjos, the Obiezekweseles, and the rest of them stood up to be counted, and even the West stood still. One day, a female will be the president of Nigeria and many other African countries, and I believe strongly that you have what it takes, we have the capacity to do this. It's time to stand up, to be counted.